It's well known that different species feed on different things. They have different niches. But is there variation within the species? Is there individual specialisation? So there's partition within the niche. And that's what I like to talk about and the consequences. And I've been filming oyster catchers on the Northumberland coast. And oyster catchers are famous for having considerable individual specialisation. So I've just been watching some feeding on polychaete worms, and those individuals tend to have pointed bills because the sides of their bills get eroded away, and so they end up being pointed. Oyster catchers grow their bills a 0.4 of a millimeter a day, three times faster than fingernails, so they can adapt to the shape of the food items that they're feeding on. And then there are other individuals that specialize on feeding on periwinkles. So here's some periwinkles here, and oyster catchers will chisel their way into there. And as a result, they will have a hook-shaped bill as they've eroded away the top of the bill when inserting into the periwinkles. And then there are other individuals that tend to feed on limpets, which they bash the side off and then eat the content. Here's a limpet I've just found. You can see that there's some flesh inside, so we know that this has been taken by an oyster catcher. It's also a bit abraded around the side. I don't know if that's where the oyster catcher bashed it. Then there are other individuals that specialize on cockles, and then many individuals specialize on feeding on mussels, like these mussels here. So different individuals specialize on different prey species. But it's actually more complicated than that. Mike Norton Griffiths said there's some individuals that specialize by stabbing between the gaping valves and then chiseling out the flesh, so-called stabbers. And there are other individuals that specialize by hammering through the sides of the shells. So as I used to study oyster catchers, I've got some of these shells here. Here's one that's been stabbed open, no damage to it. But here's one that's been hammered open, and you can see the considerable damage there. But then of those that hammer open, there's some that walk along and go through the upper surface of the shell. These so-called dorsal hammerers, they go through the upper dorsal surface. But there are other individuals that pick up the mussel and carry it and then turn it upside down and then smash their way through the underside, the ventral side. So these are ventral specialists. So oyster catchers differ in their diet, whether they stab or hammer, and whether they attack the upper dorsal surface or the lower ventral surface. And then I showed that there's greater individual specialization. There are certain individuals that just feed on by hammering open the right-hand side or the left-hand side of mussels. All of these have been attacked on the same side, and these have all been taken by one particular oyster catcher. So there's considerable individual variation amongst different oyster catchers in the way in which they feed. One of the questions is, how common is this? Is this because mussels and other items are difficult to open, and therefore individuals have to find clever ways of doing it and then specialize on different ways, perhaps overcoming different weaknesses? Or is it that there's been an army of ornithologists looking at oyster catchers, and by picking up the shells, you can see how they've opened it? So we understand that specialization in the way we don't for most other bird species. I suspect from watching birds that many other individuals do specialize as well. Perhaps not to the same extent, but I think individual specialization is probably very common. And then what are the consequences for this? It has consequences for the species themselves. So with different individuals feeding on different items, there are different consequences. So for example, those that feed on earthworms have a higher parasite burden. And as the prey changes, there'll be all sorts of other consequences. There's also consequences for the prey itself. So for example, carrion crows are famous for being intelligent, but for having individual specializations. So for example, some carrion crows learn how to find specific bird nests. And so the predation on those bird nests largely depends on whether or not there are specialists in the population. So individual specialization within niche differentiation is a really important issue.